and see about it. Going to Comic-Con, San Diego, on my way. This year is Adventure Time's final panel ever, so it's really sad, but it's not going out without a bang. We're performing 11 songs, 6 of which are mine, so we have rehearsal. It's gonna be huge. I'm gonna take you along. Made it down here, just got changed, checked in. Now we're gonna go pick up our badges and head to the rehearsal.
Burst into tears, just like, oh man, it just shocked me that I realized how connected I was emotionally to Jake and I called my wife, like, I'm not gonna be able to play him anymore. Like, ugly crying, driving. Like, bad, man. Gotta pull over, Jack. What's wrong with that dude? Wow.
And he farts in pockets and everything.
But yeah, I'm gonna miss that. The farting in
farting
the pockets.
In pockets. Yeah.
Baby, they can dance like a man. I can shake in my fanny, I can shake in my can. I'm a tough tootin' baby, I can punch in your bones. Punch in your bones, I can punch on your bones. If you're an evil witch, I will punch you for fun.
Thank you. Very serious singer, obviously.
I've heard you sing that many times. I think that was the best time right there.
I don't even know what this is. I've caught myself doing that over the years. I don't think it does anything, but for some reason it makes me feel...
It makes you feel better. That's great.
Yeah, it makes you feel like I have some control. I'm
like, is this treble right here? That's, you know what
that
is? I don't know.
That was beautiful. Thank you, Jeremy.
It's not loud enough.
It's not loud enough?
You tell him, lady.
It's not loud enough. Came here behind the front.
Olivia, you are a fan favorite. Marceline is a fan favorite, obviously. A lot of Marceline fans here. Why do you think that people are so drawn to Marceline?
Because she has problems. No, I think it's just because she's really relatable, even though she's a demon vampire, which I guess isn't relatable. But I think a lot of Marceline's storyline really opened up a door in Adventure Time that dove into these characters' past and really, really deeply dove. And so I think that people were just excited for animation to kind of go that route. Mm-hmm. So she started it.
You're gonna hear first?
Well, the writers started it, but.
Well, how do you relate to Princess Bubblegum?
Well, I mean, all the parts I play, I mean, maybe it's true for you guys too, but they're part of us. Yeah. And the more we do them, the more they become part of us in a bigger and bigger way, you know. So even the villains, even the bad guys, it's like, no, that was me when I was 14 years old. Yeah, exactly, and I went out anyway. But that's another story. So
that's adorable.
She speaks German.
Sprechen Sie Deutsch?
Ich spreche Deutsch. Ich habe Deutsch an der Universität studiert, and so it was. It was just, that was a weird coincidence.
Meant to be. Meant to be.
Yeah.
I don't even remember why she spoke German.
Yeah, why was that, Adam?
I don't remember that context.
I mean, I wrote the episode and I was like surprised that you spoke German.
So you didn't know going into
I'm crying already. This is going to be great.
I know. You guys have some amazing fans. That was really beautiful. Well, sorry to give you a question right when you're crying, Tom.
I'm Irish, you know. I cry at insurance commercials. Flo is speaking the truth, man. I love you, Flo.
And could I have a literal drum roll, guys? I have the actual release date of The Ultimate Adventure, and it is September 3rd, Labor Day, at 6.
Sitting here, over here, Ashley. Me, Hinden.
She's hello. Looking out there.
Where's the child that's speaking to me?
I just want to say I miss these guys so much. Like, seriously, yeah. The most wonderful group of actors, you know, ever. And we had so much fun and for doing this show for all this time.
Yes.
And, yes, and the finale is amazing.
Yeah, thanks, Adam, to you and Penn and everybody that gave us great stuff to say. Great stories.
You guys.
Awesome. I mean, you guys, without you guys, like, we don't really, like, exist. Like, thank you very much for loving and support all the shows. Yeah, thank you guys.
Now we've got some songs, and I'm just going to have you guys run right into them. The first one is Olivia.
with I'm Just Your Problem.
Can I stand for this?
Oh, dude.
Shouldn't have existed, so every part of it was unlikely. So while we were making it, I was like, geez, I can't believe they're still letting us make this. So, that went on for years.
So we actually have one more special guest that we wanted to bring up. Please welcome to the stage, Rebecca Shook.
Yeah! Guitar.
You've got a couple of songs for us, yeah, Rebecca?
Yeah. So even after I left,
guitar fetus.
I never really wanted to leave, and I came back to do a song for Olivia because I love writing songs for Olivia. So I want to play a song. It's called Everything Stays. I started. Olivia wrote new lyrics, and I love them. So I'll do mine, but then. Olivia will
the extended her. Version.
Got it. Let's go in the garden. You'll find something waiting right there where you left it, lying upside down. When you finally find it, you'll see how it's faded. The underside is lighter when you turn it around. Everything stays right where you left it. Everything stays, but it still changes ever so slightly, daily and nightly, in little ways when everything stays. To the ocean, the crystal tide is rising, the water's gotten higher as the shore washes out. Keep your eyes wide open, even when the sun is blazing.
love won't control the time. It could cause you to drown. Everything stays right where you left it. Everything stays, but it still changes ever so slightly, daily and nightly, in little ways. Everything stays ever so slightly, daily and nightly, in little ways, when everything stays.
Because I can't stay away, I actually wrote one last song for the last episode, and I would love to play it here.
Please do.
This song is called Time Adventure, and it's dedicated to Adam Muto. Things make sense, so we're always living in the present tense. It seems unforgiving when a good thing ends, but you and I will always be back then. 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 Singing will happen. Happening happened, will happen, happening happen, will happen again and again, 'cause you and I will always be back then. If there was some amazing foresight, sign of time to take us back to where we were, and hang each moment up like pictures on the wall inside a billion tiny frames, so that we could see it all. It would look like will happen, happening happened, will happen, happening happened, and will happen again and again, 'cause you and I will always be back then. 'Cause you and I will always be back then. 'Cause you and I will always be back then. That's what you and I will always be, best friends.
That song, it's one of the most beautiful beautiful songs ever. Period. I'm so into the characters in this show. And I mean, this is what happened when I tried to record that song. And I couldn't. It took me about 45 minutes to, like, to an hour to even get through it once. I couldn't. But it's just beautiful. And
yeah.
I'm just so honored to know you and so happy for your success and so, like, Steven Universe, like, come on. You deserve it. You deserve it. You deserve it. You deserve it. Thank you.
So, you can probably guess what the last song is.
Yes.
Olivia, I think you're gonna start us off. If you can.
You wanna have tissues?
Oh my gosh.
Band, you know, whenever you're ready.
Just a happy kid song, you know, about how all time happens at once, and so all the people you've loved and lost, you never really lose them.
Who's ready?
You guys ready? Don't worry, it's okay.
Kick it off.
We're all gonna make it.
All right, band, take it away, please.
So much.